Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, we're going to make a pivot table using the data that I have displayed. We're only using three columns, column A, column B, and column E, the invoice amount. What I want to do is show for each car brand the number of dealerships they have, and every car brand, Toyota, GM, has three dealerships. So I want to show the total for every car brand and get the grand total at the bottom of the pivot table. But then that one's the easy one. Then I'm going to add two more columns though to the pivot table. I want to know what percentage each car brand is of the grand total. So what percentage is GM of the grand total? What percentage is Toyota of the grand total? That one's fairly easy to do. But next, within each car brand, we've got dealerships. And again, there's three dealerships, XYZ, ABC, and Bill Owens Automotive down in row 17. I want to figure out what percentage the dealership is within each brand. So let's go ahead and dive right into this pivot table. Okay, five clicks to make a pivot table, but before I do, I do want a couple check figures. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to sum up the invoice amount, which is E. I'm just going to sum up E through E, the entire column. $31,643,000. I've got that number down somewhere. That's a check figure. You don't have to do that. Also, just so you know this, I'm in cell A2. I know that there's no blanks in here. Put my mouse pointer on the bottom and double click. I have 999 rows of data. And one more quick tip I would do if this was me and someone had emailed me this, since this invoice amount that I'm looking at, and we just figured out the 31 million, I select this column E. Down below is my count of 1,000 and numerical count of 999, because E1 is my header row, and you can pull all this up by right clicking right in here. Let's get started now. Here we go. Insert. Pivot table. I'm going to put it on a new sheet. That is correct. Hit OK. I want to see the car brand. I'm going to do some dragging. I'm going to put it in the rows. That's where I always start. I'm going to take the invoice amount. That was the second field I said I'm going to use. I'm going to drop it in the values. And finally, I believe dealership. By the way, there's our 306 dealership. I'm going to take it and drop it right here. Go down to the bottom. There is my total, 316 million. So everything's good so far. My subtotals for my car brands, row 4 is Acura, row 8 is BMW, are at the top. You don't have to do this, but if you go to design, you can put them at the bottom of the group. It is just a matter of preference, or you can not show them at all. I'm just going to leave them at the top. I'm going to keep the defaults for this example. So here we go. Let me zoom in just a tad. I'm going to drag the invoice amount down here again. I'm going to right click. I want to see percentages, and the percentages that I want to see, I want to know what is the Acura subtotal, row 4, as a percentage of the grand total, which is row 44. Show value as, and this is going to be the percentage of the grand total. Click it once. There we go right there. We should end up with 100% at the bottom for the grand total we do. Just to manually check one of these, I'm going to take cell B4 and divide by cell B44. I just want to see this real quick. That is a match right there, by the way. Perfect. So that was the percentage of the grand total. Fairly simple. Here comes the tricky one. For Acura, I want to know ABC, Bill Owens, and XYZ, row 5, 6, and 7. What percentage of those numbers of the Acura total, which is in row 4? I'm going to drag the invoice amount down again. Right click, show value as. This is going to be a percentage of the parent total. Click it once and you have to either pick by brand or dealership. I can tell you it is not dealership. I'll get all 100%. So one more time, I just wanted to make that mistake. It is going to be, and the reason it's not dealership is 167,9492 divided by 167,9492 is 100%. We need to divide by the brand total, the 276. And here we go. So Acura is 100%, but within Acura, ABC is 60.82%. Bill Owens is 6%. One more quick test. Equals B5 divided by B4. 60.817, rounded up. Yep, perfect. Good to go. Scroll to the bottom. I should not have a percentage here in the grand totals because I'm doing the 100% within each car brand. There you go. Let me know if you have any comments or questions about this pivot table. And feel free to subscribe and ring the bell and have a wonderful day. I appreciate your support. Thank you.